And I just wonder how much it'll play on their minds, the fact that the Malaysians, despite playing together for almost 7 years, the fact that they've never won a Grand Prix gold or Super Series title. It's their third final of the year, beating finalists in Thailand Open Grand Prix and the Japan Super Series event.
7-5.
Perhaps it'll be third time lucky for the Malaysians.
Serve is over. 6-7.
Right idea. Oh, so the spot called. Shuttle struck above the waist.
Service over 8-6.
Adi Marot is our service judge. The luck of the net cord.
Serve is over. 7-9.
It's good attacking play from the Malaysians.
Serve is over. 10-7.
Service fault called.
Service over 8-10.
This time the service judge saying racket wasn't pointing in a downward direction. China have been so dominant in the women's doubles event for so long, but most of their top doubles players retired after the Olympics. Yin Wei, Chen Jie Wen. Xiao Ling also retired. This is a good rally. Hard fought rally as well. Oh, sensational! Wonderful play.
10-0.
Put away in the end from Joe Novita. Oh, it's clever. Very clever change of pace from Chin Yi Hui. And it means that the Malaysians have the narrowest of possible margins at the mid-game interval. Beautiful.
Kalau lagi nyerang, kalau lagi bisa turun-turunin terus, kalau bisa masih boleh enak turun-turunin, jangan angkat. ya, kecuali boleh dia rating sama hati gitu sekalian, gak apa-apa ya. Terus defense-nya, defense-nya jangan lama-lama, kalau mau datang sekali ya, kalau terkencengin ya.
Well, I think some of the advice saying don't be afraid to lift it right to the back.
11-10, play.
Oh, brilliant. Good low serve, intercepting the third shot. That's just perfect. The little half court push just in a downward direction.
13-10.
And this is a very good little spell from the Malaysians. Four straight points. Yeah, but that lift is long.
Service over.
We've talked about it all week about the fact that the shuttle is flying a little bit faster going towards that far end of the court.
12-14.
Difficult in women's doubles to get the shuttle on the floor because the quality of defensive play is so good. And when you think that these top women's doubles players and mixed doubles players can defend smashes from the top male players that come down at over 300 kilometers an hour, it's no wonder that they can also defend smashes from the top women's doubles players and not smashing nearly as fast as that. And so, of course, the problem is, how do you put the shuttle on the floor? And the answer, I believe,
15-14.
Is that you've really got to say to yourself, can't expect hit winners from the back. I'm just going to work at setting up the net player so that we can finish off the rally from the front of the court. Get the net player involved. Six straight points for the Indonesians.
Hold. 17-14.
An extraordinary run. And that was right after I said that the Malaysians were having a good little spell. I know I've mentioned it already, but I do wonder whether it's going to play on the Malaysians' minds the fact that they've had opportunities before, but they've never won a major title in Grand Prix badminton or Super Series badminton.
18-14.
Eight straight points now. This is unbelievable run from the Indonesians. Yeah, that's the sort of thing that I was trying to explain earlier.
15-18.
The smash down the centre of the court from Chin Yihui, setting it up for Wong Pei Ti to finish it off from the front.
Oh!
Yeah, and again. Do you want to expect 16, to hit the winners 18. From forward in court? Well, this 18. Is an extraordinary sort of fluctuation in fortunes. Yeah, well put away from Jonavita. Really is about the control at the front of the court, which either pair gets a player dominant at the front in the rally, wins the rally. Whoops. Confusion in the ranks, and it means that the Indonesians have two game points. The nerves getting to a little shake of the head from Rani Mundiasti. Especially from Chin Ihui.
20 all.
They had the luck on their side with that net court. It's 20 all, and of course, got to be a clear 2-point winning margin to a game. So we'll continue on until that occurs, unless, of course, we got to 29 all, in which case it would be sudden death, first pair to 30. Very rarely do we see that happen. Would you believe it?
21-20.
Saved two game points, and now they have a game point themselves, the number four seeds from Malaysia. And I was just thinking, this is perfect tactics of channel attack down the centre of the court to involve the net player, narrow the angle of reply. 21 all. So now, a second opportunity for the Malaysians. They've saved two game points. Now they have a second game point themselves. And this time they convert. And the number four seeds from Malaysia, Chin Ihui and Wong Pei Ti, come back from the brink in that opening game, saving two game points before closing it out 23-21.
Second game, love all, play.
Oh, right idea.
One love.
Chin Ihui going for the drop shot.
One all.
No, just wide.
Service over, 2-1.
Service fault called. Shuttle struck above the waist.
Service over to all.
Yeah, I tend to agree with that. Wonderful net shot from Wong Pei Ti.
4-2.
Good movement as well, good balance.
Serve's over. 3-4.
Defensive shot going along of that back line. The Indonesians, if they're wanting to defend and content to defend, they've got to be awfully careful that they don't lift long. Real danger from this near side of the court as we look down. Another one. Pushed long of that back line.
6-3.
Oof, only by a whisker. What a good call by the line judge. And the Indonesian coach is looking a little glum at the moment. Oh, that's good defence. Oh, well worked rally.
7-3.
Yeah. Umpire just getting in a muddle. It is 7-3. Immediately making the correction. Well, once again, the winning shots played from the front of the court. Yeah, never came over the top of the shuttle. Hitting it well long. Frustration, I think, not being able to put the shuttle away, going for two, an acute an angle. No, pushed it wide. And there's signs that they're running out of ideas now, the Indonesians. Goodness, I made that prediction. I thought the Malaysians were imposing themselves on the match in the opening game. And then the Indonesians race back with eight consecutive points. So I don't make such predictions again.
Service over. 10-5.
You know, it was difficult to try and control that. The shuttle was tumbling.
11-5 interval.
So a 6-point advantage at the mid-game interval in favour of the Malaysians, who of course took the opening game 23-21.
Tapi siap terus, sudah nyemek, sudah siap, kamu siap terus, ya. Ini kalau bola-bola style tadi, jangan nyodok dulu, kamu netting dulu, main itu dulu aja main. Kalau nggak enak nyodok, jangan nyodok, netting dulu. Yang belakang siap, yang depan siap, ya. Tapi kalau kamu bisa nyodok, nyodok, jangan diam, nyodok cari bola, pasti bolanya sudah nyodok pasti sini lagi. Ini ya, nyodok pasti sini lagi, ya. Kecuali bola nggak enak, kamu boleh angkat, ya. Ini ya, ya, oke.
20 seconds.
20
seconds.
Their coach, former fine mixed doubles player.
Stop. 11-5. Break. Serve's over. 6-11.
Oh, that's a superb backhand from Wong Pei-Ti. Outstretched arm. Created pace out of nothing. How did she do that? No backswing of the racket. Oh, very good attacking play variation. Instead of the channel attack, there was a smash down the forehand side from the left-hander. Well, I remember when they were 7-10 down in the opening game, they got 8 straight points. I wonder if we'll see that again. 13. No, I missed it.
9-13.
Oh, certainly play the Indonesians right back into this. They could get a good run going here. And they're certainly helped in their cause by simple errors. Marcel Schulman's just saying yes, there's a feather broken in the shuttle. So indeed they do change the shuttle, get a new one. Oh, great kill at the net from Mundi Asti.
10-14.
Time is running out for the Indonesians. Oh, it's a lovely low serve. Finds
16,
the line.
10.
And Chin Yifei, who's been struggling over the last year or so with a bad back injury, really is playing sensationally well. In fact, both the Malaysian women are. Silva's fault ball once again above the waist.
Serve over, 11-17.
Yeah, good interception. Left hand up.
Serves over, 18-11.
And just 3 points away from their first ever major title in world badminton. The Malaysians tantalisingly close. Oh, it's landed in. This judgment from Wong Pei Ti.
12-18.
Somehow they've got to put the closeness of this monumental step in their careers out of their minds. Just try and focus on the next rally.
19-12.
Yeah, she has been brilliant. She's come forward at the right time. She's hunted the shuttle.
20, net point, 12.
And now the Malaysians on the verge of victory. 8 match points. It's wide. They've done it. First ever Malaysian women to win a women's doubles title in a Super Series tournament, and they won it in style. My goodness, that opening game, they lived dangerously, saving two game points. But in the second team,
23-21,
second game, they were quite clearly the better pair. 23-21, 21-12, and Chin Yihui and Wong Pei Ti take the Danish Open title. Oh, a steady progression, never more than 3 consecutive points from either pair. And 11-5 up at the mid-game interval. And they really pushed home that advantage. Still more unforced errors than their opponents, though, even though they won. But 3 times as many winners. The Indonesians only serving low, no flick serves at all. A number of service faults called on both pairs, though. So the two pairs are led forward for the prize presentation. Obvious disappointment for the Indonesians, Rani Mundi Esti and Jona Vita. But this is only their second tournament together, and it's the second time they've reached the final. That is really quite extraordinary. And they should draw encouragement from that rather than letting the disappointment of today's final get to them. For the Malaysians, well, milestone in their careers.
Rani Mondiati and Joe Novita.
So the Indonesians.
And the winner of the Denmark Open Super
Rani Mondiati and Joe Novita. Mondiati especially looks very disappointed.
And Wong Pei Su.
But for the Malaysians, their first ever Super Series title. They've never even won a Grand Prix title. So this, a monumental achievement and leap forward in their careers. After almost 7 years playing together in the women's doubles discipline, they now have the Danish Open title to add to that of Commonwealth Games gold medalists. Yes, real delight for the Malaysians, and rightly so. They've played wonderful badminton all week. Haven't rocked a game. All of their matches in two straight games. And that has been very impressive indeed. Chocolates as well. Trophies, prize money, chocolates, flowers. And of course for these players, they will be travelling on to Paris in France, probably tomorrow, for the start of the next Super Series event, the French Open. Well, they will take some of those photographs home and put those pride of place in their homes, because this, their first ever Super Series title, and the first is always very, very special. So it's been a wonderful week here in Odense in Denmark, of course, as it always is. Great organisation of the tournament. And we've had wonderful finals and a good spread of titles as well. Two titles going to Denmark in the mixed doubles, and Peter Gaeder winning his third Danish Open men's singles title. China, just one title. The world junior champion Wang Lin was absolutely superb today. And of course Indonesia in the men's doubles with Marcus Kido and Hendra Setiawan. Who can doubt that they're number one pair in the world? And for Malaysia, a milestone. Women's doubles title, the first time at a Super Series event. It really has been a terrific week here from Denmark, from all of us, and especially from me, Jill Clark. Hope you'll be able to join us next week from the French Open. But in the meantime, bye-bye.